Hi there friends, it's good to see you again. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, I want to talk about my experience as a first year student in university. I am attending University of Ottawa here in Canada, and I finished my first year this year in 2021, and I am going to my second year from September. I thought it would be interesting to, record and make a video, just in general make some record of my opinion and my experience every year and see how it changes over time. So if things go smoothly as I plan, there should be, once I'm done with my education, about 4 videos on this topic on my channel, unless, you know, I either quit university or quit YouTube. So in a way, this video is not just for you to watch and enjoy, but also for me. Before I even begin, it's very important for me to say that by no means am I implying that every university is like this. My experience is mine alone. I went to a specific university on a very special year, and whatever complaints I have, they are personal to me. You can keep it in mind for like your future, but don't think that this is my generalization of just, you know, secondary education. Also, like, a lot of my experience is influenced by my own personality. A lot of the things that I went through are just my fault. And yeah, my point is, I'm not saying that every university is like this and just every faculty, every education you can get will be like this. This is just my personal experience. So, without further delays, let's get into it. Yeah, I wanted to drop out after 2 months. My biggest shock in university was learning that it's actually so much harder than I expected. I wasn't like the smart kid in high school, I was just very average. Probably if I applied myself more, I would, you know, have higher marks, but I didn't. I just kinda chilled. I did as much as I need to get good marks, and that's it. I didn't try hard, except in art. I really, really cared about art class. But yeah, university, suddenly I learned that I have to try. I have to genuinely work, and it was a little bit of a shock. It's not like I really expected university to be easy, but I feel like there is no way for me to actually be ready for how hard it is. I had many, many instances where I genuinely questioned my own intelligence, which I guess it's a good thing, but I wasn't thinking, oh, maybe I just don't know anything. No, I was thinking that I am dumb, I don't belong here, I should just drop out and do whatever. I am too stupid for university, and it was such a soul-crushing thought for me. Luckily for me, this hardship didn't last too long. By the second semester, I already kind of got used to all the work I have to put in, and I got used to the lifestyle. I just managed my expectations from myself and also from the courses, and just it got much easier. I got more familiar and more adapted to that world. I bet this moment of shock is not unique to me, and every single student experiences that. First year is supposed to be the hardest, from what I've heard, because you get all these classes that teach you a lot of stuff in a very short amount of time, and these are really hard. And the fact that all the classes were online really did not help us at all, which leads me to the next topic of this video, online classes. Because I started university on our lovely favorite year, 2020, all classes were online, even my studio classes, which I will rant about a little later in this video. And I thought to myself, well, that's not gonna be too bad. I am a little bit antisocial by nature. I have this, I guess, very introverted personality, and I'm very awkward with people, so I'll be perfectly fine. I don't need socializing, that's great. Boy, was I wrong. That was, like, absolutely awful. The alienation I felt from my classmates was just unbearable at times. At some points, I genuinely disliked everybody because I knew them only in this academic context. I didn't know much about my classmates. I knew them only by appearance, name, and I guess political opinion, because that's what you talk about in the arts faculty. I don't know about you, but for me, I really need, like, to know people better to connect to them. Like, know different aspects of their personalities and their hobbies. But when you're in an online class, when you cannot speak most of the time, it's just impossible. After one whole year in that university, I got to know 2 people. two people who I genuinely like and I would love to hang out with once I, you know, get to Ottawa. Everyone else, I don't know them. And it's just really sad. It's really a shame that things turned out this way. Maybe I would have enjoyed my first year so much more if I had more friends and more opportunities to connect to people. I'm quite open to the possibility that, like, that feeling of alienation is completely my fault and not just online school, because my classmates seem to get along just fine, and they would, and like during group projects, they would talk about completely unrelated stuff to the class or any topics that probably came up when they were chatting with each other online. And I was just, and wasn't included because I wasn't in the same group chats or in the same conversations, which gives me really big flashbacks to high school. Oh god, excuse me. But regardless, I still think that just the fact that we were all online and could connect only like that, it really made things much harder, for me at least. For second year students, they actually get studio classes in person, which honestly gives me a lot of hope. I'm very hopeful for next year. But if nothing changes, then I guess I'll just have to repeat this exact rant next year in the next university video. With that out of the way, I'd like to talk about my classes. I had this year 10 classes in total on 7 subjects. I had English, philosophy, art history, sculpture, painting, media art, and photography. 3 of the subjects, English, philosophy, and art history, lasted the entire year and were in a lecture format. And the other subjects were studio classes where we actually got to do art. So in total, I had 5 classes per semester, all of them compulsory. I heard from some students that they took only 4 and they said that 5 is too much. And I just wonder how, if all of them are compulsory. I guess they will take some of them in their second year, I don't know. But I took 5, which doesn't sound like a lot, but a lot of them, in fact all of them, require a lot of work outside of class. I will talk about each subject separately, just briefly summarize how it was and what my opinion on it, starting with English. In the first semester, the class focused mostly on writing essays, MLA and citations, some grammar, the usage of active and passive voice, you know, stuff like that. How to write essays and how to write good essays. In the second semester, we mostly read literature, and the goal of that lesson was to teach us how to read between the lines and really get meanings behind the text. It was a very fulfilling class, like I genuinely learned a lot. Yet it was challenging, and the biggest challenge, to my surprise I guess, was language. I was introduced to academic words, to academic essays, and just English of a high level, and suddenly I felt like I am a fresh immigrant again. I just forgot how to understand. I sort of pride myself in how quickly I learned English, because like after 1 year in Canada, I could transfer from an English class in high school for newcomers into just a regular English class. I thought like I'm okay, that my Angliski is good enough, but suddenly here I am in university and I cannot understand a thing. It was so weird, it was just mind-blowing to me. And because I have this very unhealthy habit of constantly thinking that I am the problem, I just thought to myself, well, my English isn't good enough for university, clearly. I should go back to high school. It was really, really bad. But eventually, I overcame this problem. Once you get used to the fancy language, you just kind of realize that, after all, the meaning is quite simple behind every text. I guess scholars just like to make it harder for us regular folk to read. And that's all. That's it. Once you get used to the fancy language, it gets much easier. In philosophy class, I had the exact same issue, though in the first semester it was okay because we're mostly focusing on theory and just very simple philosophical concepts. In the second semester, though, that's when all the text came in and all the reading. In fact, in the second semester, I read so much, my brain was melting. In philosophy class, I actually genuinely liked it. It was one of the very few classes that actually stimulated my mind and made me think and question the world, which it's, I guess that's the purpose, yeah. It's really good. I got an absolutely lovely professor, especially for the second semester. He made every class so engaging, and his lectures were really a pleasure to attend to, no matter how hard and confusing they were. I think every subject can be made easy and enjoyable if you have the right teacher. Now with the non-artistic classes out of the way, I'd like to talk about my studio classes, starting with media art, where there I again got the best professor could have asked for. Just very engaging, very clear with the guidelines, and just really pushing with the expectations. I feel like media art class pushed me to the very limits of my creative abilities. It was very challenging because I'm not that familiar with videos in general. I don't really do creative videos like I do for YouTube, but that's not the same thing. So I really like that challenge, but I still got enough help from the professor. We all did, and it was just a pleasure to do. Same thing goes for photography class. I had a really good professor, and the projects were so much fun. That one was a bit easier for me because I have more experience with taking photos and editing them, but still just the right amount of challenge. I really enjoyed photography and media class because I think incorporating technology into art is just very good and very relevant to our day and age. My third studio class was sculpture, and that was bloody awful. My main criticism for this class is the materials we had to use. Keep in mind, all of us are sitting at home with unclear living conditions, yet our professor sends us messy and potentially dangerous materials to work with. I am lucky because I still live with my parents where we have a nice big kitchen, and I could work there without, you know, endangering anybody or making a mess in my room. Some students were living in the dorms, some students were working from their tiny room, and our teacher had no regard to that. I think it's really, really unfair, and like, considering the circumstances in which we had to learn, maybe it would be a good idea to adapt the curriculum a little bit, you know, use a better material. Like back when I was in my art middle school, in the first year we were making sculptures out of cardboard, and it was fine, it wasn't as messy, but here in university they're giving us plaster and silicone, stuff like that has toxic fumes or toxic dust that goes everywhere. It just big hazards, very dangerous, and I think like that was such a stupid move and from like the professor. And the professor themselves, they were so unclear with their guidelines and expectations. Like we had half of the time, none of us knew what the hell we're doing because we just get very vague instructions. It's like, yeah, do the thing. That's all. I have no idea how I passed this class because damn, I did not know what I was doing most of the time. But on the bright side, one of our projects was to sew a stuffed animal out of other stuffed animals. Just make really creative sculpture out of old toys, and that was lots of fun, and I just made this abomination bear with four arms and four legs. It was so beautiful. Moving on to my last studio class, painting. It was okay. Painting is kind of my thing, so I expected to enjoy it, and like I did enjoy the painting. We had very basic projects like do a self-portrait or still life or a landscape, because this was just the introduction to painting class. Like some of my classmates never touched acrylic in their life, so yeah, that was basically the purpose, just teach us the basics. We had a lot of creative freedom, like we had our themes, but we could really expand in them. And I guess it had the same issue as with sculpture, like some of us didn't have easels, some of us didn't have rooms for that. But the professor was much more understanding. To be honest, like, I think it would have been much better to teach us drawing instead. That takes much less room and much less money, but like whatever, it was an okay class, that's all I can say. So to summarize my opinion on the studio classes, some of them were bad, but they were mostly good. I enjoyed it, it was nice. My main complaint about the studio classes is that all of them are so bloody early. in Ottawa time, they start at 8:30 a.m. But for me, it was 7:30 because there's a time difference between Ottawa and where I live currently. So I had to wake up early, and I'm not a morning person. It was just really annoying. I would be half asleep most of the class. Yeah, that's my main issue with the studio classes. They were mostly fun. Last but not least, art history. And I kept that one to the very end because the amount of misery I experienced with this one class just deserves some extra recognition. I got the most boring, uninteresting, unengaging professor I could have possibly got. It was awful. Every lecture is just 3 hours of pure boredom, pure misery for me. I would dread every week, just every day I'm thinking, oh no, soon I will have art history. It was such a dark spot in my entire schedule because I just hated it so much. Our art history professor had no idea how to lecture properly, I swear. They would stop at every slide for like 10 minutes repeating the exact same thing, maybe like 5 times if not more, because their mind would wander to some other place. And I guess some people are like that. But you're a goddamn teacher. A teacher should know how to teach. Especially when we are paying to get this education. Why do we have such low quality educator? At other instances, our professor would fiddle around with the computer, with the Zoom or with their PowerPoint, and just completely get lost in the technology. And again, I have sympathy for people who are just not tech savvy. I am not. I understand. It's hard. It's really hard to get used to. But other teachers did get used to it. Other teachers figured it out. Why couldn't our art history teacher not? And it didn't get better. It was bad in the first semester and it continued being bad in the second. No improvement whatsoever. How? But here we get to the juiciest, spiciest part of this art history rant, which is politics. Our professor would go on long, very long political rants every lecture. I swear, they would take a quarter, if not a third, of our lecture. And I'm not complaining because I disagree. In fact, I agree with most of my professor's opinions. But that comes instead of learning art history. And they like to mask it as, oh, it's relevant. No, it's not. And especially because they would repeat the exact same thing every lecture. Like, I get it. This political thing is bad. This political thing is good. We got it the first time. Please, just shut up. Please. And at some point I thought maybe I am crazy. Maybe it's just me. I have issue with this. I might be the only one, but it's not just me. I felt so validated when other students complained about it too, that they're tired of hearing the exact same thing. They're tired of not learning art history, but instead learning what political opinions their teacher has. I think that's such a waste of everyone's time. We were behind our schedule every semester. Like, there were things we did not have time to learn. Partially because, well, because our professor doesn't know how to teach and they get stuck with the computer, and then when they are not doing that, they're just ranting about politics. Like, sorry, I got heated up there a little bit. It was just an absolutely terrible class. I swear if I did not have art history, I wouldn't want to drop out as much as I did. If it wasn't a compulsory class, I would have dropped it immediately. Like, after 1 month, I would just, you know, dip my toes in and run away. But no, I couldn't drop it because it was a mandatory class. But I still learned quite a lot. I learned a lot from this class. I mean, from the textbook. Because by the second semester, I just completely stopped listening to the lecture. I just read the textbook. I just studied from that, took notes, and then I passed my exams. And it was perfectly fine. Who needs a professor when you have a perfectly good textbook? Excuse me, I went on a pretty long rant here, I'm sorry. I'd like to bring up again the good parts of university. Studio classes were genuinely fun. We got to do stuff, we got to practice and learn new stuff. philosophy class, very engaging, very just mind-blowing in a way. I felt like my mind was expanding. English class was very useful, a little boring at times, but still very useful. I learned some valuable skills that I will definitely use in the future. But when I look at the big picture, I think despite how terrible, how bad the bad parts of education was, it still is very outnumbered by the good parts. So in the end, I decided not to drop out and to do my second year, which thankfully will be in person this time. And also, it is supposed to be easier. I heard from like the student mentors that second year is where your program actually starts. You're done with all the compulsory classes and you actually get to choose your classes. I chose my discipline to be painting because that's my thing, that's what I'm good at. I also am taking Japanese classes. I started studying by myself somewhere around December, and I thought I should take it a little more seriously, and I'm taking Japanese classes. It's gonna be fun. I still have art history and I'm just praying that I have a different professor. I also decided to try out English class focusing on creative writing just to see how I do. If it goes really badly, I can always drop it because it's not compulsory. Haha, I'm lucky. I'm excited. So far, like as I'm recording this, unfortunately, I'm still in the waitlist for the creative writing class. I really hope I can get in. But yeah, that's my status right now. What I guess is the most pressing question in a topic like this is it worth it? Is university worth it? And to be honest, I can't answer that yet. I will have to, I guess, finish it or get to my third year or something. I don't know if it's worth it, all the work and all the money. It's a really hard question to answer. I feel like for some people it works out, for some it doesn't. A lot of opinions on YouTube especially are very negative about art school, so that kind of can really affect your opinion on university. But for me, some of it is bad, some of it is good. Is it worth it? I don't know. I can't tell you yet. I might have the answer in a few years, or maybe not, because life is very confusing. Tell me your experience with university or high school, whatever it is you're doing. Just tell me about it. I'm very interested to hear. If you're interested about the painting I'm doing in the background, that is posted on my Instagram. Link is in the description of this video. I might make prints of this artwork because I love it. I'm very proud of how it turned out. Or maybe not. I don't know yet. If you wish to support what I do, please check out my Etsy shop and my Patreon. These are linked in the description as well. Subscribe for more videos, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye!